guys, it's me again. Today I have a massive haul. I had a 2-week holiday from work about a month ago now, and I've had all this stuff sort of sitting in bags waiting to show you guys, but I haven't had a chance to film in a really, really long time. I spent a week here in my hometown of Brisbane and then a week in Sydney. Now, I had a friend come over from overseas. Her name is Inna, and we just shopped and shopped and shopped. So yeah, I kind of want to break it down to what I bought from my hometown and then what I bought from Sydney, so that you can kind of get a feel if you do come to Australia, that, you know, the kind of shopping that you might want to do. But it's not that different. I think Sydney just has more markets. So. Yeah, so without further ado, I will get started. It's very hard to know where to start. I probably should have categorized it. But what I will start with is Topshop, because Topshop opened up in Brisbane for the first time ever, and I'm so excited. I even watched it being built, and I kept hinting to my boyfriend that he should buy me vouchers for Christmas, which never happened, so I should get right on that. I don't even know what we got each other for Christmas, actually. Does anyone ever even remember what they do on Christmas Day? I never remember. But anyway, enough of my rambling. I have a bag. This is not Topshop. Where is my Topshop bag? Here. Okay, I'm a little overexcited, guys. So I have a bag from Topshop. I didn't buy a lot of stuff from Topshop, but I was just excited to mostly just go there. And so the only clothing item that I bought from Topshop is this really, really soft, plain blue t-shirt. It's got little cuff pieces there. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys, I have a tattoo now. This is my first tattoo, so this is going to start popping up on a lot of videos. This is the Deathly Hallows symbol from Harry Potter, and it's my first and last tattoo. I just thought some people might ask about it because it's new. But yeah, this is the top that I got. It's really soft and it's got a very flattering neckline. It's just a soft V neckline. Now the rest of the stuff from Topshop is pretty much all makeup, because I go crazy for Topshop lipsticks. Okay, so I have 4 Topshop lipsticks, and I also have 2 nail polishes. So I'll show you the nail polishes first because it's easier. It's called Skip, and that's just like a peachy pink, I guess you could say. And then I got another color called Venus Flytrap. I love that name. Which is pretty much just like a, what do you call that? I don't even know what you would call that. A green, a limish green, limish greenish color. Now, the 4 lipstick I got, I'll just show you this way. I might just do a swatch. I'll do swatches and like cut to a swatch shot. I'll be really fancy and do editing stuff and be really cool. So because otherwise, if I put it on now, I'm gonna get all over the clothes that I'm about to show you. So these are the 4 shades. So you have All About Me, which is, you know, like a fuchsia pink. And I'm sure right now you're looking at a cut video. That's really cool because I have great editing skills. And then I bought Infrared, which is an orange color. I think this one's the famous one that Zoella likes from Zoella. And then I bought 2 similar toned colors. One's called Wicked, and that is the lighter of the two. I guess you could call it a light maroon. So the last one I have is the Damned, and that is a very sultry, deep maroon color, which is going to be really good for autumn or the fall, whichever you call it from wherever you're from, because it is currently autumn in Australia at the moment, but you would not know it today because it is hot, and I've got a window right behind the camera, so you can probably see how bright it is. But yes, so that is everything from Topshop. I had a lot of fun in there. Okay, the next thing I want to show you is from Brisbane again, and this is from Paper Scissors, which is a really, really good store. I never really shop there that often, but I really like it now. And now, these are 2 items that I deliberately bought in a size smaller than what I am, thinking that, oh, I'll buy a size smaller and I'll fit into it in a month and I'll be really skinny. But it never seems to happen. I think a lot of girls do this. But the odd thing is, this dress, which I will show you, It's so beautiful.
So that's the neckline, and then it cinches in at the waist, and then it's really just sort of like form-fitting to the knees. And then at the back, it's also like a V-neck at the back, and it's got this see-through panel. And I love it. It's very, very flattering, and it does actually fit me because the material is very stretchy. Now this other thing that I have is kind of hard to show, and it doesn't fit me, so I can't try it on and show you, but I am excited to wear this. I'm really hoping that I can fit this by the time my graduation rolls around for my acting school, and that is in about, I think, a month and a half, 2 months, and I should be able to fit into it by then. It just fits now, but it's like cutting into my legs. So it's a pantsuit, technically, like a one suit pantsuit, you know what I mean, a play suit, long pants, one piece, whatever. So that is the front. It's so, so nice, and it sort of just covers your boobs there, and then it has this high cut neckline, and at the back it just sort of like has, you can't wear a bra with this, it would just defeat the purpose. And then it sort of stops at these little hot pants, and then it becomes see-through, and then the legs sort of flare out in this like see-through material. So they are a pair of pants, but you've got these little hot pants underneath it, which I thought was awesome. And so hopefully you will be seeing photos of me, or maybe an outfit of the day, in about 2 months' time when I have my graduation. So fingers crossed for me for my diet. Okay, so the next thing I have is from Ali, another chain store that we have. And I really like the bags. Pretty little things inside. Or does it just say pretty things inside? Oh, I can't read. Pretty things inside. I only have one thing from Ali, but it is pretty. And it's a little crop top with straps. And it's perfect for these high-waisted shorts that I have. So that you only see about that much skin around the waist that is exposed. And I really, really like that look. So yeah, this is just really cute little bustier. It's $10, so you can't really go wrong. Okay, so the next thing that is still from here, I haven't gotten to Sydney yet. this one is from Chica Booty. I think you pronounce it Chica Booty, but it's a pretty awesome name. Now, I bought the same top in 3 different colours because this top looks amazing on. It doesn't really look like much on the mannequin or the hanger, but as soon as you put it on, it just changes your life. That's how much I like this top. It pretty much, this is really hard to show you, but that's what it looks like. So the front of it goes like that, so it just goes against your skin, and it goes quite high up around the neck here like that, and the back of it ties up, which is good because then you can sort of control the size a little bit. And it's quite stretchy, soft material, and it's just a little crop top, which I like to wear with skater skirts, and it's just really nice for a night out, you know, at a restaurant or the movies. And so I got it in white. So I got it in maroon, and the last colour, which I don't have a lot of this colour, so I thought it would be nice. And it's a cobalt blue, I guess you could call it, cobalty blue, which I really like. I think the blue one's my favourite. Ever since I dyed my hair darker, I'm kind of wearing different colours to what I used to, and I think blue, I really like blue now. So the next thing I have is from Lovisa. I bought a, this is pretty excessive, but I love it. Does not go with what I'm wearing. But I bought a crown of flowers, and it's not even summer anymore, but it's just, I really like it. And it's the only one, ugh, it's like dripping fluff. But yeah, it's the only one that I found that I think actually sits properly on my head. It's still huge, which is the point, but it actually sits well. It doesn't look too stupid. But I don't know. I really like them. I think these are a love-hate thing. You either love them or you hate them, and I love them. But
For those less daring, I bought a daisy chain as well, which I thought was cute. So it's just something that goes like this over the head and just really cute for summer. And I thought the yellow just really stood out with the dark hair. Something a little less terrifying than the big flower crown. So I have two things left from Brisbane before we move on to the stuff from Sydney. And I bought a clutch bag. This was actually when I returned after my holidays in Sydney, but it was bought here because I was going out with my friend Katie and I forgot to pack a clutch bag to go out in, and you just don't want to take a big handbag. So I bought this clutch bag, which is a pink and orange block color bag, and it has a gold chain if you do want to use the chain, and it just looks like that inside. It fits a lot of stuff though, it fits just the right amount. And that is from Colette, one of my favorite jewelry and handbag stores. So I think, yeah, this one was $15, so super super cheap for a clutch bag that nice. Okay, so the last thing I bought from Brisbane, now this is again something I bought after I got back on holidays, but I'm just including it at the beginning. I bought a new Tangle Teaser. Now this is their new water version, so they're to be used in the shower because it's got this big hole in it. Now the reason for the hole is so that if you're brushing your hair in the shower, you know, if you've got a standard brush, the water gets all under the cushion and it just goes gross. So that's why they've created these. But I honestly don't really use the brush in the shower. Maybe a little bit if I'm doing a deep conditioning treatment to just sort of brush it through. But I don't really like brushing my hair in the wet, even with a Tangle Teaser, because I feel like it's so much more fragile than what it normally is. So I just use it just normal. You can use it just normal. It doesn't have to be wet hair. And yeah, Tangle Teasers are just something that I'm always going to be sticking to. One of my most popular videos is the Tangle Teaser versus the Michelle Mercier brush. And everybody, there's a big debate in the comments about whether which one's better, but I honestly think the Tangle Teaser wins by a long shot. Although I will say, I think I was using the wrong type of Michelle Mercier brush. So if you want to watch that video, go and watch that. I don't know why it's so popular, because I filmed that in the dark, on a whim, didn't even really think about it, just had an idea and filmed it, but there you go. It's kind of annoying that my least favourite video that I don't really like is my most popular video. But moving on, that is the Tangle Teaser. Okay, so in Sydney, I met up with my friend Verna, and Verna and I have a little bit of an obsession, just a little bit of an obsession, with Priceline. So, that's my Priceline bag. I bought, this wasn't with Verna, this was my second Priceline trip in Sydney, but I bought the Killer Queen Katy Perry fragrance. But I want to show you the bottle. It's so pretty. This is the bottle. Love it. It reminds me of something out of a video game, like if like something that you put into a lock, or a vial of healing potion from Elder Scrolls games or something. Okay, so the next things that I've got from Priceline are two more Real Techniques brushes. Now, these are the brushes by Samantha Chapman and Nick Chapman from the Pixie Woo Sisters. And I bought, so what did I get? I got the setting brush, which is just, it's a nice sort of fine powder brush, so you can just set under your eyes. Just, I don't really like using a big powder brush, so I bought one of those. And then I also bought the Expert Face Brush. So it's just like a little buffing brush to put your foundation on. And they're both dual fibers, so nice, just amazing brushes. I can't fault their brushes. I think given the choice, if I could only use one makeup brush, like brand, for the rest of my makeup career, I would choose Real Techniques. Me and Verna were looking at Pond's, and Pond's have just recently had that big revamp of all their packaging and their products. So I decided I wanted to try one of their BB creams. And this is the Age Miracle BB cream. I was saying that I wanted to start using a couple of anti-aging products. I know it might seem a little too soon, but once you get to about your mid-20s, it's a good idea to start using just a little couple of anti-aging things just to get you started. So I just thought a BB cream would be perfect. I tried a little bit on my hand and it was really nice texture, very silky. So I'm looking forward to actually applying that properly and seeing how it goes. Now, the last thing I got from Priceline is a recommendation from Verna herself. She has been using this stuff since, I don't know, she said forever. This is the Nivea Firming Body Lotion, the Q10 Plus. And she credits this lotion for her firm skin. And if you look at her, she's got a really toned, tight body. Yes, she works out, but she thinks that this stuff is keeping cellulite at bay as well. So she puts it on every night though, and she said, you gotta put it on every night. So I'm gonna put it on every night. It's not opened yet, but I'm definitely going to be trying this out and seeing how I go. One more thing that I got from Priceline, I forgot about it because I wasn't in the bag, is the Vaseline Spray Moisturizer in Cocoa Glow. Now it looks like a fake tan, but it's just a moisturizer and it's a spray-on moisturizer. So you literally like go like that and you've got moisturizer on and it absorbs so quick and I love it. I think I'm going to be alternating between using this in the morning and the Nivea cream at night. So that's everything from Priceline. Now I want to move on to what I got from Sydney's Paddy's Markets. I love Paddy's Markets. They're not particularly as cheap as you would like it to be for a market, but you can pretty much haggle everything down. So the first thing that I got is, I can't even read this, so I don't really know what to say about it, but all I can say is that these are those sheet masks that you put on your face. I don't really know why there's a picture of a baby on there. I'm assuming because you're going to have baby soft smooth skin afterwards. But the whole lot is in Japanese. All I know is there's 5 sheets and the girl just recommended them to me because I told her what my skin type was and she told me to use these. So I trusted her. Now, the next thing from the markets is this jumpsuit. I've already worn this, so it's a little bit crinkled. I just wanted to show you before I threw it in the wash. And it's this little jumpsuit. This is my favorite style of jumpsuit. The V-neck, tied at the waist, and then flares out. So it almost looks like a skirt. And yeah, it's just, I've been living in jumpsuits all summer. I really have. I love jumpsuits. Now I have a bikini, and this was, I think, $15 for the Bikel bikini, including the bottoms. So it's just like a polka dot, almost pin-up style strapless bikini, but you can put a strap on and click onto it and have a halter neck strap. And then the bottoms just look like this. They're just plain polka dot bottoms. Oh, and this one is my favorite purchase from the markets. I think every person and their dog has one of these, but I don't care. They're flattering and I love them. These are those skorts that everyone seems to wear. Again, I've worn these, so they're a little bit crinkled, but they are a pair of skorts. So they come in like triangle shapes at the front, and then they are just a pair of shorts at the back. So it's a skirt at the front, shorts at the back, so they're a skort. And these are high-waisted ones, particularly wanted high-waisted because I'm just sort of liking the high-waisted look at the moment. And they're very flattering, they're very slimming. And the other day I wore this top tucked into it, and I love this top. This is another jumpsuit that I got from Sydney, and it's a deep V-neck at the front. And it's also a very deep V-neck at the back, so you've got to be very careful that your strap doesn't fall off your shoulder. I recommend if you've got anything like this, wear tape. It just makes you feel a bit more secure. So this is a jumpsuit, again, very loose, but it's got this like cool cutout part at the bottom. I really like that laser cutout type thing, whatever you call it. And yes, so that is everything from the markets. Then I went for a wander around to the Mac Pro store. to buy a lipstick from my friend Katie when I was coming back. And while I was walking to MAC, I found this makeup store. I think it was called The Hub. And apparently they've got one in Brisbane and I had no idea. And they sell Lime Crime. And Lime Crime are these cool lipsticks that are packaged in purple with a unicorn on it. Couldn't be any more girly if it tried. And even the lipstick inside is the same packaging. And I bought a rather interesting shade. It is a green colour. Now, I was actually going to wear this for St. Paddy's Day, but I totally forgot about it because I woke up late that day and it just never ended up happening. But I think I could rock this. I don't know. I want to try wearing it out and see what kind of reaction I get, just to see what would happen. But I actually had a hairdresser do my hair and she was wearing this shade and it looked really, really good on her. So you never know. Maybe we'll start a trend. Now, the last two things that I want to show you before I finish off my haul. I work for a telecommunications company full time. And we are very lucky. We get a lot of benefits. And one of them is access to the Estee Lauder, it's just kind of like a warehouse where they sell a lot of older stock, so a lot of it is very cheap, anywhere up to 90% off, but it's not always older stock, it's just like excess stock, I guess. I don't really know the details, but it's the corporate store. So Estee Lauder own a lot of brands like Clinique and MAC and everything, so I didn't buy anything from MAC. There wasn't a lot to choose from, but I did buy my favourite hairspray. This is the Aveda hairspray called Air Control. It smells amazing and it keeps your hair in place and it's not crunchy or anything. It's shiny and nice. And it was $18 and I think in the store it's about $37 if memory serves. So couldn't pass that up. And the very last thing that I bought is this teeny tiny little mascara from Clinique. And it is a bottom lash mascara. And it looks like that. Very, very, very tiny brush. And I bought it in brown black. Just because I feel like the bottom lashes just need a little bit of like, just during the day I just don't want them to be black. I just want them to be a bit more neutral. So yeah. It stays there, it doesn't smudge, it's amazing. Yeah, so that's from those places. And then I also bought another makeup item that I almost completely forgot about. This was a airport purchase from the Benefit counter. And it's the new Benefit Gimme Brow. And it kind of just looks like that Clinique mascara actually. But it's for the eyebrows. So it looks like that. And this is supposed to build upon your natural eyebrows. I bought mine in the darker colour, medium deep. And it just sort of builds upon your natural eyebrows and makes them a little bit thicker, not just filling them in with colour. So I'm wearing it. I like it so far, but I feel like I still need to put a little bit of powder with an angled brush just to make the edges a little bit neater and cleaner, because it's very hard to get the brush in a very neat line, and I like neat lines. So that's my only thing about it, but it definitely saves time. I spend a lot less time filling in my eyebrows now. So that is everything that I bought on my holiday. So that's my holiday haul. I hope you guys really enjoyed it. My next video, if you've been noticing me talking a little bit funny or with a lisp, it's because I got Invisalign. Invisalign are invisible braces, and I'm going to be making a video on my experience so far, and if you guys want to see that, let me know, but I'll be doing it anyway. yeah, I just wanted to discuss it and talk about why I did it and what kind of results I'm looking at, and then I'm gonna, because I'm kind of like halfway through now. And then at the very end, I'll do another one showing the difference. And then I'm also getting a couple of other things done to my teeth after I finish. So I want to explain that and just talk about teeth, because I feel like teeth should be included in beauty. So why not? So that is everything. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.